Hello, thank you Cosmin to invite me, thank you Tina to invite me to this interesting conference. I will present in my paper shortly both the conception of religion and spirituality, and we will compare the new visions of postmodernity with the psychological view before investigating the contribution by the different currents of a transpersonal and integral approach can provide a dialogical perspective of transcendence and inclusion of the different positions. Keywords of this paper would be religion, spirituality, integral transpersonal psychology, participatory dialogue, circuit of experience, and transcognition. Go to religion. The Oxford Dictionary derived the word religion from Latin religare, refer to all the aspect of the human which recognize with the divine, the transcendence, that which is greater than us. On the other hand, religion seems to indicate the link between the human and the divine, the recognition of a higher power, and on the other hand, to emphasize the aspect of caring. The religion also is the one who takes care as opposite of the negligence. But more recently, the scholars have started to understand religion as a way of life, which, as Nelson say, has to do not only with the transcendent as it is out there, but also as it is immanent in our bodily life, daily experience and practice. Ninian Smart, for example, expresses this concept in the broadest way, including the following dimensions: practical and ritual, including prayer, worship and meditation, experiential and emotional, narrative or mythic, doctrinal and philosophical, ethical and legal, social and institutional, materials including building and other artifacts. By his side, postmodernity tend to desacralize, de-transcendentalize, relativize religion, assimilated them to linguistic expression. The linguistic approach tend to neglect the religion experience for itself, to focus on verifiability or falsifiability of religious beliefs. Speaking on transcendence, the postmodernism, for example, with Ferrer, with the participatory vision, says that transcendence is also to listen to the other and overcome the hierarchical dualism. Or, for example, Nelson speaks about weak transcendence and hard transcendence. The weak transcendence means that in everyday life we find any moment something, a step to go through. We find in any moment something to go beyond, that is within our reach. For hard transcendence could be intended the theism, where the belief in God transcends both us and the world, and God becomes the object of devotion. Speaking in spirituality, for example, the Treccani Dictionary defines spirituality as a set of elements that characterize the ways of living and experiencing reality, both with regard to religious form of life and with referencing to philosophical, literary and similar movement. And nowadays, the term spirituality typically indicates the experiential and personal side of our relationship to the transcendence or sacred, means that spirituality could be understood more as an experience, and religion could be understood more as an elaboration of the experience, a framework in which put and organize the spiritual experience. For example, Nelson say that spirituality should be understood as a state of being, a way of feeling, thinking and acting involving the sacred, the mystery. Or Shannon, a search for higher values, inner freedom and things that give life meaning. We could say with Nelson that there is a thick definition that usually is linked with the religion system and practice and believe. There is a thin definition that is more focused on natural experience, personal value, or connectedness. So we can say that this variety of definition and the complexity of the view of spirituality and religion call for caution in study spirituality and religion with a scientific attitude. This could be a relationship between religion and spirituality too. Simplify. The psychological view of religion and spirituality offer a sort of tools to try to understand and try to lead with spirituality and with religion. For example, the postmodern and transrational view of Ken Wilber offer maps and models to differentiate the prepersonal mythological content with transpersonal and transrational experiences. The same experience, the same spiritual experience or religious experience is very different if it is lived with the mythological thinking or with a transpersonal, transrational approach. Wilber speaks about waking up and growing up. We can wake up, have a sort of transpersonal experience, religious experience, spiritual experience, but we can have not grown up enough to organize this experience in a correct way. We have not the maps, we have not the way of thinking to organize. And these maps, as Wilber remembers, are so hard to spot, but they weren't discovered until around 100 years ago. This is the reason why integral transpersonal approach can help in understanding. We will see this map in a while. We can go for the psychological views. Was William James in the end of 19th century that concentrate his focus on the stream of consciousness and on the variety of spiritual experiences as psychological experience. After them, Freud relegated the religion as something that fostered the illusion and prevent people from being in touch with the reality. From humanized God, reading the divinity as a symbol of the potentiality that human can reach. And also Maslow, peak experience are the core of human experience, and they don't need religion to be explained. They are simply naturalistic experiences. And he believes that all religions are in essence the same, and the differences are only apparent. The transpersonal approach sees religions linked with the state of consciousness, a state of thinking, as a self-realization process, and underline the cultural differences of the multiple religions form. Main points of the integral transpersonal vision are participatory dialogue between the self and the world, the circuit of the experience, the hermeneutic means, the farther mode. We could say that everything is a dialogue between I and the world that happens in the field, means that the circuit of the experience is me, you, and the field. When we speak about something, we should speak about something that is interconnected, me, you, and the field. So we can speak about spirituality or religion as something that is separate by the relationship between the person that is live the experience, the world, and the field around. And also, any experience is not only a things, means, spirituality, religion, but also a mode in which way we live spirituality, in which way we live religion, with which state of consciousness, which stage of thinking, how we organize our experience, in which context, and also where and how to understand the integral vision. We can use this map, the square and circle model. We could say that the circle is the spiritual experience, and the square is the religion, means the way we organize. But also we can say that the square, the thing, the event, the appearance, and the circle is the way in which we look at the world, and is the where, the context where the experience appear. Square is the hermeneutic, and the circle is the experience. We can separate the experience with what I do to the experience and the place where the context where happened the experience. The square could be the I, and the circle could be the world. And always this happens together. There is no way to separate. So the first point of transpersonal integral vision is the interconnectedness of everything. Interconnectedness of me, the world, into the field, and the impossibility to separate is the invitation to go beyond any dualism. In a tree, it is one, me, you, and the field, the things, the mode, and the things and the mode, the part, the wall, and the wall part, together. We see experience hermeneutic. How we can manage the spiritual and religious experience in this dialogue, me and the world, thanks to the circuit of the experience, feeling, thinking, acting. I feel something, I experience the world, I have a spiritual experience, I organize this experience with the mind, with the thinking, and I act and I behave following the way I am organizing. We could understand that the way I organize the experience, the stage of thinking, is crucial in understanding the spirituality and the religion. There is not one spirituality, one religion, but is depending on the state of consciousness and stage of thinking of any person. How we can master our spiritual experience? Thanks to the levels of our self, physical, energetical, emotional, mental, spiritual. Mastering all these levels, we can say something about spirituality and religion, and also the hermeneutics, the experience and the way we organize the experience. Any content, anything, any event happens in a way. And also, we could ask, who is experiencing? When I say me, I don't say something that is ever the same. When I say me, I say a lot of person inside me, sub-personality, archetype. So the subject of the experience also could be understood, answering to the question who we can differentiate the spiritual experience depending on the who that is living this experience, and also the how. So in which way we are experiencing, and also where, in which context. So try to enter better in this who question, how question, and where question. As we said, everything is a ternary experience. I call this trans, the part, the whole, and the whole part. Me, you, and the field, always a part of me, a part of you, or a part of the world, and the field where this happens. And all this is included into the essence, the spiritual experience, the religion, the divine, we could see as the bigger circle, is always experiencing thanks to the trauma, thanks to the relationship that is three, is not two, me, you, and the field. And this me, you, and the field is depending of state of consciousness, a stage of thinking. This me and you is depending of sensation, moods, feelings, visions, thought, insight, intuition, that happens in all my bodies, is happening thanks to the relationship between the knower, the feeler, and the doer. This knower, feeler, and doer, this dialogue between me, you, and the field, this trance, this participatory dialogue between me and the world, this circuit of the experience, me, you, and the field, this feeler, doer, and knower, always happen into this hermeneutic circuit of the experience, acting, feeling, thinking. As we can see, the key is in the thinking, in the way of thinking. And we can say, we can think through cognition, through metacognition, or through transcognition. To simplify, state of consciousness could be pre-rational, rational, or transrational. I can have a spiritual experience through the instinctive consciousness, rational consciousness, intuitive consciousness, or unitive consciousness. This growing up, pre-rational, rational, transrational, make the difference of the religion experience. And also, stage of thinking. I can have a peak experience, I can have a great spiritual experience, and I can organize this depending of my stage of thinking, my growing up in a mythological way, or magic or archaic way, in a rational way, or in a psychic, casual, and not dual. Thanks to a transrational way of thinking, there is a way of knowing that I call transcognition that helps us to recognize that spirituality and religion are always two sides of the unit. Anytime I have a spiritual experience and I organize thanks to an hermeneutics, thanks to a framework. This framework could be a great religion, or simply a like vision. This is always a way of connecting the within with the without. And we can say the more we go from archaic to non-dual, the more our experience could be able to get the unity between spirituality and religion, to go beyond the differences and get the integral experience that is both spiritual and religious, that is both experience and hermeneutic. So the word question, where, archaic, mythological, psychic, non-dual, where I am? I am in a dual state of consciousness, stage of thinking, or I go to a unity, both-end attitude. The how question, I am making the two one, or I am dividing? I get at a stage of consciousness where I go from the dual world of knowledge to the unity world of awareness, or not? If I am in cognition, in metacognition and transcognition, this makes the difference. Cognition get evidences and separate Allah, Buddha, Christ, spiritual experience, religious experiences. This is better, this is worse, this is me, this is you. Metacognition get the structure between and help us to go toward the unity. I see the similarities between Buddhism, Hinduism, Hebraism, Christianism. I see the similarity, but I am still differentiated. Transcognition is aware of the process and the structure that go through. So I see the pattern that connect everything. I see the unity of the process and I can get the unity. So this helps me to transcend, include instead of separate, and do this through second attention, further mode, and what I call integral transpersonal thinking. Second attention. There is not only what appears on stage, but there is also something beyond the stage. What is happening indicates beyond, and I would have always this attention to get the beyond of the appearance, get the backstage, get the mode of anything. The further mode, when I, thanks to the second attention, I get the backstage, is able to transcend, include, to have this attitude that see that the within and the without, the stage and the backstage are one. The bigger circle you see, get the stage and the backstage together. This is a way to get the unity. I see the difference. I see what is white and what is black, but I see also what is unifying black and the white. And integral transpersonal thinking, shifting from first to second attention, getting the unity beyond the duality, thanks to the further mode, I can be aware that I am not thinking, but I am thought by the cell. And to get this integral way of thinking beyond the ego, in the connection between square and circle, to be thought by the essence, to be thought by God, I can get this capacity to be thought by God, by the essence, by the unity, by the self. Doing these four steps, be aware of what I call explicit clinical evidences, the world, what is happening in the world, thanks to the five level, physical, energetical, emotional, mental, and spiritual contents. I get what comes from outside. Implicit essential inherences, I get what is happening inside. So in the same moment, I get the outside and get the inside, the without and the within. Thanks to explicit clinical evidences, implicit essential inherences, I expand my consciousness to go from instinctive to rational to unitive, intuitive and unitive, to go from pre-rational to rational to transrational, and I get the field that unify. I get the unit. This way I can put together spirituality and religion, hermeneutics and experience in a unitive integral experience.